Okay, without wasting much of our time, we now call on the way out to give us to present for us a documentary that you guys will be able to watch and learn and see how best to find possible solutions towards these problems. We have to debate on these issues that are affecting women in our society and also young ladies in our society. Thank you.
Good morning once more. Good morning once more.
Good morning.
Please look someone and say hello.
Hello.
Someone by your side, please.
Hello.
Okay. Thank you guys for coming. My name is Mr.Gibrilla Kamara. So I'm here today to represent WAYout. And WAYout is a charity organization that works with streets and disadvantaged young people across the country. So we show short documentary which was done in the provinces behind Bobo or Bundubu village. And like you say, issues like affecting women across the country, like it's very invisible, people are not aware about. So if you watch the documentary, you have any question to ask, I'm open to answer, or maybe like if anyone wants to answer it, you're welcome. So stay relaxed and enjoy the documentary. Thank you.
This white pity, una don't let come. Enough time for greedy woman. Woman enough of time. Because if they back like that, what they do, not so they take me. If woman don't plan to pass, they don't plan for food. What is woman that will do anything? It's not easy. Because at the end, it's not the best. And I enjoy that we in the community that woman is not the load. The heart of the woman is the total. You know, the case is the one you make now. Really, it's sorry, and really sorry.
It's very pity to see that in the 21st century and of the world and these kind of things are happening. You know, abuse is something that is very, very harmful to human beings, more especially if you are the victim of it. Because it's not wholly destroyed the person's self-confidence, but it can also affect them psychologically, physically, and even mentally. Because if you are a victim of this kind of act, it will be a way to decrease the way you see things, and you won't be able to even stand out and say something that would impress others. And I think the main thing we need to do is to change the mindset of these people, because it's all about the mindset. The cultures, some people in this part of the world all work with cultures and customs that they believe in. So if these organizations, or let me say institutions, or even the government try to create a change in their mindset, it can help a lot. Because once you change the mindset of people, you can see that things will be going fine and well. So that's all. Thank you.
The comment goes, it's like the humanitarian feelings of those chiefs and husbands are less. We talk of the respect, they have no respect for women. Because if they do have respect and humanitarian feelings, they will not be abusing them as they are doing. It's like they have forgotten where they are from. They don't know how it takes women to give back. They don't know the pain or struggle they went through to give back. So if they know the pain and the struggle, Allah, they will not be. Let me say abuse. What is abuse? It's purely abuse. They abuse women. So I don't know what you guys are putting in place to stop this abuse.
It is very important for all of us to see these things that we are just seeing. It is educative. But what I am here to emphasize on is this early marriage. Because early marriage is something that will disturb the female's education. Nowadays, we are seeing most of these girls, they have not yet reached the age of 18, but their parents forced them. They forced them to get married without even completing their school's academy. So I want to know what are the strategic plans that the organizers need to put in place to stop this early marriage.
A man cannot force a woman for sex. It's undone, as my brother have just said. Men should know that we are their sisters, mothers, and daughters. They don't know that we are powerful. They are taking the right that they are men. Yes, they are men. I think as an organization, what you should do first is you should stop early marriage. Because when a girl or a woman is not educated and that woman is being sent to a married house, that woman will know that she is powerful.
As an organization, we try our best to see how we can empower these women in this village for them to believe in their self-esteem, to know their rights, because that's what the problem. When someone doesn't know his rights, can't take his stand. That's why we are here. So like if you know your rights, someone can tell you, let's have a sex four times, then you do it. It's not right. But more like the village, these children grow up in the community, like they have a tradition they're always used to hear all the time. When they see the beat your mother, then the mother will come back and say, this is a boy show. But if someone is there and tell them this is not right, then they get the understanding. I think the education needs to be taken in these places for them to have the understanding. Thank you.